with our campaign in EU4 with Ethiopia. We are back with Ethiopia. I was playing not very much this last week. I think this is even the first time I played this week. I was buying a game called Pathfinder Kingmaker, and I was playing this, and therefore I'm not really sure what's going on, but I just found out that we are at war with Sakalava. I knew I wanted to get their trade and all the rich stuff from them, so I'd like the shortcuts. What's that? W. I was just finding out. Ah, I see. Is it like that? Yeah. I was just finding out that that's why. Ah, I see. I was just looking around for the shortcuts, and what's that? You? Why is it you? That doesn't make any sense. Ah, I see why. Because I've got the wrong keyboard. Yeah. Why is that? Oh, and P is the rebels. Ah, yes. Of course. And it's Y and not Z. Because the shortcuts here are for English keyboards, and I'm using a German keyboard. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Let's do some war. This will be easy. Let's go there. What? The triangle trade. Oh! When European nations started to colonize North and South America, they created large plantations for production of cotton, tobacco and sugar. First they tried to use the local population as slaves, but they quickly died out when it was tried. Slaves were then imported from Africa, which created a triangular trade system. Europe sold textiles, rum and manufactured goods to Africa. Africa sold slaves to America, and America sold cotton, sugar and tobacco to Europe. This was kind of interesting, this kind of trade. Not very nice, but it worked quite some time. So, yeah, oh, we are fine. And we have 22 days to siege. Yay, and we got some conversion done already. That's good. So, let's see. There is another conversion done in 14 months, 0.6. Yeah, that's quite good. Madanda, can we make this faster by doing an edict there? It's here. Okay. Now states. Where's the... Oh yeah, there's the edict stuff. And we have the religious unity there. That world. You see, we have a lot of red already. It will be even better soon. Yeah, I was looking at my situation and I see now that I was really too slow in conquering the Mamluk countries. I should have been more aggressive with the Mamluks to get rid of them. Yeah, now I've got some issues. anyway, with the Ottomans, because the Ottomans are too strong for me. So my reasoning now is we'll wait until the Ottomans are attacked again, really bigly. Bigly, can you say that? Probably not. And we are trying to get richer faster than the Ottomans. So we are trying to conquer quite everything down here. I mean, we conquered already everything down here, except Mutapa. And there is this gap between the East African side and the West African side, which is a problem. I mean, there are still, I still don't see any Europeans here, which is interesting. They're probably all back to the New World. I mean, even here in North Africa, you nearly have no Europeans. Ah, yeah, there are Europeans. There are Portuguese, and there is a bit of Castile. But mostly it's, oh, Gibraltar is held by Portugal. That's nice. And there is still Burgundy. Austria. I mean, it would be great if I could get the Commonwealth in helping me out with the Ottomans. I'm not granting military access to countries like Tavazir. Yeah, that's my reasoning. I'm going on a killing spree. So, I'm going south. Ready? Okay, to Muscat as well. Why are you here? Where are you from? Come here, fetch these. I mean, we're probably doing war next in this direction. Ah, I know what you wanted to do. There are 20,000 separatists. Yeah. You stay here. You go there. There are still 2,000 people. Look at that. Where are you from? deplete. population of the European beaver? Really? Why is there only one ship here? Why is this ship alone? Why is this ship alone? Why aren't they with these ships? Ah, I really hate them. That's good. Ah, come on. Let's capture this. That's the way. So let's see, do we have some military leader around that we can put in charge? 4-6 and 5-3. Don't like this guy. So let him move to best on play. Get rid of him. Kill some more. Let's kill some more natives. Conversions, yay! Where did we convert now? Somewhere around here. So, Hafun. Hafun is up there. I think there was also one. There's also the religious unity. Yep. And it's the last one in this region. Great. Yeah. Can we just occupy this floor? That's good. We don't have to occupy this. This is my country. Ah, I'm so stupid. Oh, I forgot. Sorry. That's a problem with having too many troops and too much land. You really forget what you wanted to do. These 20,000 were going to do some things up here, and we want stuff from you like this. But also, what do we want? We want good countries, like high development, 7, 5, 4. We want a lot of money. We want a lot of money. Yeah, there is no high development countries here. But if we have this, we get, nah, not really. I mean, it really doesn't matter which stuff we take. So let's take this. Let's, first of all, transfer trade power, war reps, and all your money. 200 gold pieces is quite okay. And with the rest we'll take just everything that we can. Probably we should look at regions, like taking just one region like this. Like taking all the coast up and down. Yeah, that's nice. We'll have to wait until he's doing that. I mean, actually he will do this. Our navy is on attack. Yeah, that's that's nice. This cog thing is going there. This caravel thing is going there. See, we arrived in Barra. Oh yeah, that's okay. Oh yeah. There will be some fights soon. Did we capture ships? Yay, we captured a ship. It was just a cog, but the cog is better than nothing. So I was Deal. Do you already take this peace offer from us? Yeah, you'll take it. That's good. Let's do this. It's even better like that because we didn't have to actually attack this country, so it's not devastated. There again, we've got a few troops that will take care of you, and you are getting my troops back from here. So we've got some money, we've got some land core. We'll do this. And oh, even more. Just didn't see. And we have too few rivals, so we can make a rival. The Commonwealth, Austria and Ming? Yeah, let's rival the Ming. We really don't want to rival Austria or the Commonwealth because, I mean, they really are natural allies of us in the fight against the Ottomans. But probably the Ottomans are still too far beyond us. So, what's that? Yeah, this is a caravel. You will protect trade. I don't think that we need the protection of trade. This was a misconception of myself. I thought if we would protect the trade here, we would get even more money. Probably we even would, but we get most of the money out of this node. I mean, we also get the money from Sekalava, so it's okay if you're not protecting here, but protecting somewhere where we could transfer trade power to us, like in Gujarat. How about Gujarat? If we protect in Gujarat, it will be transferred to Zanzibar, probably. No, to the Gulf of Aden. Why to the Gulf of Aden and not to Zanzibar? I mean, you can transfer directly to... Can we tell him when to transfer that? In the Gulf of Aden, we are transferring to Zanzibar. So if we protect in Gujarat, we'll transfer it to the Gulf of Aden, and from there we'll transfer it to Zanzibar. So probably we should protect in Gujarat. Where is Gujarat? There is Gujarat. So we are stronger there. Yeah, you can still protect here. No. Yeah, you can still protect in Zanzibar. It's okay. It's not too bad. So also we want to do more manufacturers. I mean we want to create manufactories in regions that have really good trade goods, like gems and ivory and coffee. But we can't do them right now because we need admin tech 14. diplomatic tech for the ivory. And even slaves would be quite nice. This is also diplotech 14. And what's that? Incense. Ah, but it's not that good. Also diplotech 14. So diplotech 14 and especially admin tech 14 to 16. This will take some time, probably. We'll see. I mean, we are at 11 now. Yeah. The next big project will be to get colonialism. I'm not sure if I even started that. Can I see the edicts? State edicts. Where is this? Is this with diplomacy? Yeah. Encourage development. Local. Oh, yeah. It's like there. A printing press, not colonialism. Ah, here we have some region where we have already nearly printing press in Soba. It's a grain province, so it was okay doing the manpower clicks. It's 108. Burghers are illoyal. That's too bad, but we can't do anything about that now. Not really, at least. I mean, we could make the clergy happy if we give them some money. And if they're up to more than 60%. I mean, we would get to 60% with that. Then we would get what? Minus 10% stability. Yeah, that's not too good. So we only have two subjects at the time. We could have taken Sakalava as a vassal, but I think it's not that important. We will probably try to get a vassal. Probably I'll take the state edicts and put it somewhere here. How can we? Ah, yeah, it's like that. It's like, can we get state edicts there? Really, really nice. So we can, with the shortcut I, we can change this view and we can see the state edicts. Enforce religious unity. Yeah, we don't need it there anymore. I mean, we have already Coptic provinces there, so that's just costing us money. So let's put it away. As we are not doing manufactories, or probably some manufactories. Oh no, we don't have the money, so probably churches, nah. Workshops. Oh, there are good workshop regions, like in Mombasa and Fasukli. Where is Fasukli? Oh. Anyway, we're doing a workshop there. Someone said we don't need the trade power. I'm not sure if this is true. I mean, trade power is not probably is probably not related to whatever we get there. Let's dispose of these rebels. We have lost our conquest, casus belli against them. Yeah, we have now a new rival, so we could officially try to embargo them. Let's do this. Where is this? Issue an embargo. Because of our power projection. I mean, it's low anyway, and I really don't know how other people get it up, so... Why do we do a spy network on Davasir? We don't even bother them. Or was I just hoping to... I really don't know. Oh no! The Ottomans are at war with the Mamluks. Really? Why? Ah, we can rival the Ottomans again. That's great. That's great. Let's rival the Ottomans. Is Davasir a friend of Necht? Can this be? I mean, we can't declare war on the Mamluks right now. I believe we still have a truce with them until 1574. This is really bad. Do we have a claim on them? Yeah, we have claims. At least we have a claim on Hedjaz, and there are these two claims, yeah, which will help us to get to this country of the Ottomans. But at least Necht is doing something about that, so the Ottomans won't actually conquer too much, I believe. That's good. That's really good. I hope this works out well for us. ...17,000 Ottoman troops. I really hate you, Ottomans. How about this? Is it going well? Yeah, we won. That's good. So, which kind of guy do we put here? Like this one. He's a really good general, and he can also siege, and he will do the work for us when we declare war on some of these guys, which we will do as soon as we've got the diplomat from the back from the from Ming. we probably shouldn't improve relations with this guy. So, what do we want to do next? What which war do we want to take next? Like with Afghanistan. Afghanistan or Malta? Gujarat, Delhi and Afghanistan, or with Gujarat. Yeah, we'll probably take Afghanistan because then we've also get the war with Multan, and we can try to break the alliance of Multan with Gujarat and Delhi. So when we declare war on Gujarat, we only have to do war with Delhi as well. They are all behind on tech to us. Hopefully. No, they are not. Multan has military level 13. Really? Gujarat has 10. But what do we have? Oh, we have 13. Okay. So how about attacking Baluchistan? Do we have still a... Yeah, we have a truce with them. That's too bad. They are guaranteed by Afghanistan and Gujarat. And they have an alliance with Hormuz. Can we attack Hormuz again? Ah, now we also have a truce with them, but only until June 1572. So not too long anymore. And that's great because we have this claim on Dashtistan and Ziraf with our vassal Fars. So this will be also a nice war to come up. Do we have some claims on them? Yeah, here. We've got a claim on them. Do we have a claim on Sharjah? Nah. So Afghanistan will be the next war probably, to get some money from Multan. Mainly to get some money from Multan and get their alliance broken with Gujarat. And to get some land from Afghanistan, like our vassal likes these two coastal provinces. Which is great, I think. And yeah, I mean they are allied with Transoxiana, but they are huge, but they have a lot of rebels, so probably they are not going to war together with them. So we probably fight only Afghanistan, and let's see. If this happens, if we'll clear war, yeah, well, they have the iron debt, but still they will follow. Yeah, but I mean, it's they only have tech 11, they have only tech 10. We will beat them. Hopefully. So, how about these ships coming down? Because I really want another army up there. I mean, we have this army, but they stay here. And we'll take this army up there as well. So, we have two armies to take care of these lands. But this will be done only next time. I will do in the in between 1 hour of my shows, I will transfer the troops up there, and next time when we start, we will start war with Afghanistan. Let's see if we can be as successful as all the other countries that tried to conquer this land. Okay, until then, I hope we'll see each other soon. Bye.